everybody. Because you guys like seeing lots of videos about laptops, and I happen to like laptops, especially when I can get them from thrift stores for about 20 bucks these days, I thought it was time for another laptop video. In this case, it's a couple of laptops that are pretty much the same model, but in two different form factors. So we have this little guy here, which is pretty much the same as this one over here, just a whole lot smaller. So this is, here we go. This one is a Dell Vostro. I believe it's like a 131. And yeah, it's a nice little laptop. It's got a second gen i3 processor running Windows 7 with a nice little cool little fingerprint scanner. Very cool. And yeah, it's got all your standard kind of things. The keyboard is in good shape, and I've got all the drivers for it, so all your function keys work. You just have to get the right drivers, and you're good to go. This one, like I said, it cost about $20. I actually went on a day that they had a sale, so I ended up getting 30% off one of these when I went. But it's got a HDMI, it's got a USB, card reader, not much in the front, some lights, and some front-facing speakers. There's your lights. And on this side, you got yourself a headphone, a couple more USB. We got a VGA and your internet connection. On the back, I don't have the battery in this one, but I got a battery with it, but I don't have it in there. So it has a power connector back there, and that's about it. I think there's a Kensington lock or something there, but no biggie. So that's the first one. I bought this one, and then this one showed up like a couple days later, and I bought this one. And I couldn't test either of them, so that was kind of a risk. But the price was so good at 20 bucks, I just thought, well, let's give it a try. So this one has a little different setup. It has a eSATA connector, so a little tip. A lot of times at Value Village or Savers or Goodwill, they'll often have the PVR expander hard drives that would expand a PVR. You can use those with the eSATA cable, and they work just like a hard drive, and you can use them as a backup solution. So this thing has HDMI, it has both headphone and microphone jack. It has a card reader. Similar layout in the front. This time, though, no front-facing speakers like the other one does. I believe it has, let's take a little quick peek if I can get under here. It's kind of heavy. Does it have any speaker? Oh, maybe. This looks like it has a couple of little areas. Maybe that's where the speakers come out of. Not sure. We'll find out, and I'll look for some speakers when we open it up. But there you go, there's that. So not much in the front. Swing it over to the side. This one actually has one of these PC slots. yourself a DVD drive, three USB. Let's go around to the back here. Let's see what we can find out here. Oh yeah, that's where our Ethernet. We got another VGA slot. And this one, it's got the old power. So there you go. So that is pretty much all there is to speak of on the outside of this guy. Let's just open her up here. Okay. Take a quick peek at this one. So yeah, so the bottom, obviously those little slots are where the sound comes from. So I don't see any speaker vents or grills or anything like that. So there you go. It has a couple little things underneath. Sound isn't awesome, but it's a laptop. You never get good sound of a laptop, in my opinion. If you really want good sound of a laptop, plug in some speakers into the output, headphone output. Anyway, same scenario, very similar looking keyboard, with the exception that it has the old numpad there. And you know, it's got everything. It's got the drivers, so you can use all the little buttons, function keys, which is nice. So yeah, that's the fun part, is finding all the drivers, but I did. Dell has a lot of them. There's a couple that you have to find elsewhere. Particularly the software for running this guy. So, just go like that. And we're in business. Oh, am I getting a little bit of a funky little strobe going on here? Ah, well, that's not cool. Yeah, okay. Well, apparently my phone has a little bit of a strobe going on. Can I change that by moving it? Nope. That's just the way it is. Okay. Well, sorry about that, guys. A little bit of a flicker. It's not like that in the real world. Anyhow, guess how much it cost? $19.99. Valley Village. So there you go. That's a picture of it when I first got it. So you can see the water wiped it off. All right, guys, so let's get into it. Since it is just strobing, I don't know how much longer we want to put up with that, but maybe we'll give it a try here. So here's the basic info on the i3. Okay, sorry about that. I just had to stop my filming for a second. So, back here. Okay, so the magic of film editing, stopping what you're taping. All right, so there you go. There was some basic info about the i3. And I got the latest box. So that updated at 2012, which kind of gives you an idea of the age of this laptop. So it was a 2011 laptop. It came with 2 gigabytes of RAM, and I found another stick that matched up with the same frequency. So now it's dual channel, and I got one Samsung stick from 2010. And the one I added, which was this one from 2011. So that was a good upgrade. Graphics are the standard Sandy Bridge integrated graphics. I believe it's the 3000 series of HD graphics, Intel. You know, so that it's decent. Like, I find that ever since, like, say 2010, 2011, integrated Intel graphics are okay for basic stuff. further to what's set up on this thing. So you got yourself a Windows 7 Ultimate. You got your Intel, which we already talked about. Talked about most of the stuff, the graphics, like I said. It's the Intel graphics. It's got about a 250 gigabyte Western Digital hard drive. All the temperatures are running pretty good. It's got obviously the DVD, and it's got Realtek audio. So let's go over and check out that Western Digital hard drive. So we're looking at a decent hard drive. It's got how much usage? Let's take a look here. It's got 195 days usage. So, it's got lots of miles in there. Not showing any problems. It has an interesting little thing called fall protection. So I guess if it senses that you drop the laptop, there's a mechanism in there that probably parks the heads and prepares for impact. So that's kind of a good thing. I don't know how well it would work, but you never know. Anything is better than nothing. So swinging over here, here is the rundown of the components. As you can see, there's nothing, no drivers missing. So that's one of the things I always like to make sure of when I'm messing around with a new laptop, is I want to make sure that I have all the drivers so that all those components are functional. And this was a nice little thing to find, which was the biometric device, which is the fingerprint scanner. I had to go to, believe it or not, I had to get the actual software for it, which I believe is called, let's go in here, let's see here, it's called, there it is, it's called Digital Persona. I had to get that from HP because Dell didn't have it on their website. So tip for those who want to try and set this up, yeah, you can get the driver for the device, which is a validity sensor, but you're going to need like an actual fingerprint application that manages your fingerprints and actually interfaces with Windows and the whenever you need to input a password. So tip for anybody out there who's going to set one of these up, you can get it apparently from HP, because it was an HP piece of software. All right, I'll probably get around to putting this up on all the drivers and stuff up on archive.org, or the Internet Archive, as it's also known, if it's still around by the time I get there. I think it's on its last legs. I think it's going to be copyrighted to death. So there you go. Here's the basic info on the Nova Bench. I'm about to run it. Before we do, I'll just quickly look at this last little bit of information here, which is all about the Windows Experience Index. Let's take a look. So as you would expect, typically it's the 3D gaming graphics and the Windows Aero performance that usually are the lowest scores. This one actually is decent, like gaming graphics score actually, so that's kind of interesting. And again, sorry for any flicker or whatever you're seeing in this, but for whatever reason, I guess the refresh rate is kind of funky with the old camera. So here we go, the last step in the process. Let's do this. Let's benchmark it. Maybe it'll actually complete itself. They want me to turn off all my extra things that might be running, so let's turn off a couple of these. I think I know I can get rid of this. I can get rid of this. I think all the rest of them. right, guys, let's see what this thing does. Here's our floating point operation. Transfer speed is kicked in here. And there's the other one. It always shows a blank indicator. And this is what we want to see. So what are we looking at here? Oh, I see over 100 FPS. That's great. So you could get maybe a little gaming out of this thing. Not terrible, but, you know, a little older games would be fine, I'm sure. Okay, here we go. 508. So, you know, not bad. Not as good as some of my systems, but certainly not as bad as others. And what really concerns me most of the time is this right here. So the graphics score is 30 with an FPS of 105. So you know what? That's quite acceptable for, you know, most use case scenarios. And having that extra RAM really is going to expand its usability as well. So there you go. So that's going to be my video about a couple of laptops I just picked up. $20 a piece. Actually, this particular one that I'm looking at here was actually, believe it or not, came to about $15, $16 because they had a 30% discount on the day that I picked it up. I didn't even know, so it was kind of like a nice bonus. There you go, guys. So, I hope you enjoy another little show and tell, I guess, of a couple of laptops. I'd show you this one running, but it would be a little bit of a production. So, there you go. Now, as you know, I have to always do some kind of copyright music after every one of my videos, because you know what'll happen is those freaking ad people will come and they're gonna get me. They're gonna get me. I just say no to ads. Okay, so I got some music all set up here. Let's do it. Okay, guys, that's gonna be it. So there you have it. And another laptop video. Hope you're having a great, I guess it's Wednesday today. That's a new one. I never do videos on Wednesdays. But there you go, you get an extra bonus. And I'll talk to you later.